Yes.
Are you Mrs. Spring?
Yes, I'm Mrs. Spring.
I'm Casey of the Journal. I'm here to get a story about Mr. Spring. Could you tell me something about him?
About Mr. Spring? Yes, I could tell you a lot about Mr. Spring.
Oh, thank you.
Sit down, Mommy. Mister, what do you want to know?
Oh, when he was born, his full name, when you were married, you know.
Oh, I see. Yes, of course. William Henry Spring, that was his full name. He was born in, let's see, 1874. Yes, he was just 69. We were married in 1894, and he died today.
What did he do, Mrs. Spring?
Do? Why, he did everything. What was that question?
Well, I wanted to know what Mr. Spring did.
Oh, what he did, yes. Well, it's hard to say.
He was a farmer, wasn't he?
Yes, but...
Mrs. Spring, maybe you could tell me how you met him. Something about your courtship.
Oh, yes, all right, I will. I'll just tell you all about my day, about my Mr. Spring. I always like to remember that day. I met him, it was at a box social at the church. We girls packed the lunches, and the boys would bid for them to get their pardon.
Whose lunch is that, Mary? You know?
Oh, yes, I know.
It's so pretty. All done up in blue paper. Is it yours?
Yes, it's mine, Uncle Martin. I'll be quiet. I want to see who buys it.
Could you hope I do?
Well?
Come on, you can tell me.
Well, Billy Spring.
Billy Spring?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, but Mary, he's just a plain boy. So shy. And look at that funny cowling.
Oh, I know. And his big shoes and his blue shirt, but, oh, I hope he buys it.
Any more bids for this one? Hold on.
35 cents.
Who? 35 cents. Going, going, gone to Billy Spring. Here you are, Billy. And your partner is Mary Jenkins.
Yep, that's just what I reckon.
Did you hear that, Mary?
Oh, yes, but let's pretend we've been talking and didn't hear. He's coming over here.
He's been watching you all the time. He knows what you've been doing. I'd better leave you alone.
Oh, no, Uncle Martin.
Bye, Mary.
Hello there.
Oh, hello.
You're Mary Jenkins, aren't you?
Yes.
I'm Bill Spring.
Yes, I know. Oh, I mean...
That's all right. I wanted to buy your lunch. I bid 35 cents to get it.
Yes, I mean, that's nice. Shall we sit down?
Let's go way over there in the corner.
All right. Maybe you won't like the lunch now that you've bought it.
I bet I do. What's in it?
Oh, there's some chicken sandwiches and cold chicken.
Well, what kind of sandwiches?
Well, jelly.
Oh.
Oh, you don't like them? Well, I put up the jelly myself last summer.
Sure, I like jelly sandwiches. As a matter of fact, I love jelly sandwiches.
Well, no, there's really nothing there that we can print in the paper for.
I thought everyone should know about Mr. Spring. He just died today. And I thought the paper would
be... I know, Mrs. Spring. We'll find something. Why don't you just tell me some more?
More? Oh, yes, there was much more, but...
Just whatever you remember. We'll find something we can use.
I was 20. One night, a very special night. I was 20, and so was he. He was so slim, so blue-eyed. I remember that night so.
The roof of your room.
Oh, forget about that, Mary. Here, sit on this side and here in the moonlight.
Oh, it's pretty.
Yeah. I got an extra special one tonight. Just for us. Now, this is my favorite spot. This apple tree all in blossom. Mm-hmm. Mm. Love as pretty as it is.
Oh, you talk such beautiful foolishness, Mr. Spring.
Well, again, I have so much to tell you. I wish I was one of those port fellas so I could tell it to you real proper like. But I'm not, so I'll have to be satisfied with my hems and haws.
Oh, go on, Mr. Spring.
Well, you know that little plot of land I bought?
Uh-huh.
Well, it's doing all fine now. Little spots of corn are just bursting out of the ground, and it's rich land, Mary. It's warm in your hand.
Well, you've worked hard.
I love to work hard. I feel good when I know I'm working towards something I want.
Well, just what do you want, Mr. Spring?
Oh, a little bit of land, like my little bit, and a beautiful white house. A greenhouse, Mary. Right now, I just have a little tumble-down place, but it's too big for one, isn't it? It needs to touch a soft hand.
Well, what are you trying to say, Mr. Spring?
I want you to be able to spring right here. Will you?
You're sure the moonlight isn't deceiving you? Or the apple blossoms?
Oh,
to be Mrs. Spring. Oh, that's almost more than a girl could dare wish for. To be spring all her life.
And yes?
Oh, yes, Mrs. Spring, yes. I want to be Mrs. Spring forever and ever.
I see, Mrs. Spring. Did your husband become a very successful farmer?
Well, we had to work hard. We only had a little place, but we fixed it up.
Oh, wait a minute. Did he develop any new farm processes, or was he prominent in some farming organization?
No, nothing like that. Oh, I don't know what to tell you. I thought, but I can see in your eyes there's nothing. You shouldn't have come here at all. I'm just a foolish old woman, I can see now. There are hundreds of important things about Mr. Spring. But there's nothing you can print in your newspaper.
If only the world could see the ones we love as we see them. If they could understand their inner selves as we. To know them for what they truly are, rather than for what they seem to be. There is no great news story here upon which to pile black scare heads. No scoop to stop the presses. Nothing to widen the eyes or raise the eyebrows. On the city desk, just Mrs. Spring and a desire deep down to have the world know her husband as he was and as he still is, within a thrall of her memory clawing obsession.
Get that, Spring. Yep, Eddie. Up. Oh. Hello, Mrs. Spring.
Why, hello, Mr. Spring.
Oh, there.
Is that water cold, honey?
Oh, yes, I just brought it up from the well.
Oh, Mary, you're the finest wife a man ever had. And you know, we've got quite a farm here.
Yes, it's a fine farm, Mr. Spring. You know, I think it looks prettiest just at sunset.
That's a pretty sunset, too. Pretty sky, the fields, they're pretty. And you're pretty.
Oh. Are you sure?
Always.
You never get tired of holding my hand, do you?
Yeah. Sort of brings us together more, man. Two of us are strong. At least when we're together. You know, I only wish we had our house. That special house.
Oh, that doesn't matter. We have little Billy.
He's probably crying for you right now.
Oh, no, he's on the porch. I'll hear him if he cries. He just lies there and looks with his big blue eyes. I think they're as blue as yours, Mr. Spring.
William Spring, Jr.
Oh, he's our eternal spring, Billy. He's something to work for. Something as solid as this earth.
Oh, it makes me feel good, man. All this. It makes me feel like clean.
Yes. Yeah. Hold my hand tighter, Mr. Spring.
That was in spring. But that fall, the frost was in. It's like a nightmare remembering. Everything seemed to crash. All the hopes of a lifetime.
Oh, look at it, Billy. The whole crop is dead. It's all gone.
It's
all right, Mary. Oh, but just look at them. They're horrible. They look like children dying.
Oh, Mary, don't. See here, Mrs. Spring,
you mustn't. Oh, but Billy, it means it's true. We're at the end of our rope.
No, Mary, darling. No, we're not.
Oh, but Billy.
Here, hold my hand, Mary. That's it. Now, don't cry. There.
Oh, Billy, everything we've worked for, planned for, everything we've filled with our hearts and hands, it's gone.
No, Mrs. Spring, it's not gone. We still have the best land of all, young Billy. And we still have each other.
But what are we to do?
Oh, the crops above the ground may be dead, but there's still richness and power in the earth. We can't give up. Wait until spring. We'll plant again and hope again. And someday we'll have that special little white house. Oh, we've so much to hope for. Why, we have a whole lifetime ahead of us, man. 50 more springs.
That was the worst of all, that fall. And that winter, he died. He died just as suddenly as the crops had shriveled up. Everything lost me. I didn't want spring to come again. Nothing quite. And then I got sick. I didn't want to live. But Mr. Spring held my hand. Do you know, all day he would work in the field, and at night he would sit by my bed and hold my hand.
I wish the Uncle Martin might be a little better. But you think? I don't know. The doctor said that tonight would be the worst. If you still have an illness, you may get well.
Perhaps I'd better stay tonight.
Oh, no. It's kind of you to stay during the day. I'll be all right.
Look so tired.
I can't be tired, Uncle Marty. Mary needs me. The doctor says he's lost his strength. He has to wait a little. He needs someone to hold on to. And that's someone to be me.
Yes, you're right. But I'll come early in the morning.
All right. He'll be here. Then, die.
Oh, that's right, Mr. Spring. I'll take you for me. Somehow, he made me know he was there. He made me want to live.
Mary. Can't go, Mary.
He talked to me and I could hear him. But I couldn't talk to him. His hand was strong, kind as he was. It was like a pill that a ship could tie to. A ship that was drifting away.
Oh, my God, it's all right, Mary. Don't say you're not afraid. There's no corpse of pain.
You're here when I buy that little white house. Hold on, Mr. Spring. Don't want to leave me. was a long, long time ago, wasn't it?
Yes, a long time ago.
What about this house, Mrs. Flynn? Is it your house?
My house? Oh, wait a minute.
It looks like almost a little house.
It is a little house. But I can't tell you about it. It was just last year that Mr. Spray asked me to go for a walk.
Now, where's the minute, Mr. Spray? Stop right here. Let me get out this big green hat.
Whatever are you going to do with that?
I'm just going to blindfold you.
Blindfold? Yeah. Are you still a foolish little boy, Mr. Spray? Your age. You can't help me to play games.
Oh.
What did you grow up?
Stop jabbering, Mr. Spring. I know what I'm doing.
Sometimes I wonder.
Oh, still.
Now. Careful. Not a thing.
Fine. Now, just take my head. There we go.
There we go.
Oh, I'm sorry, darling.
Oh.
Not very far.
Oh. This is silly, Mr. Spring. Oh, he was a great